getting you on top of a platform, so...
Yeah, I agree. I don't know, it's just like, it's so dependent on whether or not Peach has a turn up or not. It's pretty interesting, to be honest.
Oh, yeah. That shield poke.
Yeah, that'll happen sometimes. Like, down smash is so... It's actually probably like the... Honestly, like, down smash is like one of the most like reliable shield pokes in this game, aside from like Marth down tilt probably, but even Marth down tilt can have space. Down smash will just kind of whittle the shield down enough that it will poke.
Oh, yeah.
Because there are good hitboxes on it. What's up, everyone? Welcome back to the stream.
Yes, Donut. It is. Ooh. It is me.
That was a great...
Oh, yeah, side B up tilt.
Great side B up tilt.
Yeah.
So that's nice. The kind of stuff you need to know in this matchup as a Marth player. If you don't already know, now you know.
Yeah. Can't Muska, like, crouch cancel that, though?
And yeah, you
get, like,
can.
A down smash or whatever?
Yeah, you can. Yeah. But he has to know.
Yeah.
I mean, at that percent, because it's like one of those things, right?
Yeah.
If you're at that percent, you're probably not going to crouch cancel.
Yeah, otherwise you're going down.
Mm.
Bottom corner of the
but if you know the side B's coming, probably a good idea. Then we're getting some people rolling in through chat. What's up, everyone? Please share this. Ooh, not quite.
Yeah, that nah, we living. Yeah.
That would have been a pretty early kill, honestly. That was like a lower 100 on Peach.
Yeah, but Muska was on like the complete opposite side of the stage, so...
Yeah. And not gonna lie, I thought the energy levels might have been a bit low, but I'm reinvigorated at the moment. Ace. Oh, great recovery, actually. Oh, and the counter! So small!
Oh, he grabs him out of that. Oh, nice read.
Ace is making a lot of good decisions at the moment. He's doing a lot of good stuff.
Nice dash dance,
I'm liking what I'm seeing. Liking what I'm seeing quite a lot. Alright.
That's it.
Yeah, that'll happen.
Nick popping off for your boy, Ace. Nah. I hate that kill throw in the forward throw.
Yeah, yeah, it's a bit of a... It's like you don't know like where to DI it sometimes, you know?
It's like one of the few kill throws in Melee anyway.
Yeah.
That you're just like never used to it.
Pretty much.
Oh.
Oh my god, that's such a brutal tipper.
Yeah. Musket in a rough spot, yeah.
He's actually, like, Ace has actually got the percentage, which is pretty...
Yeah.
You don't really see that. Like, you just trade a lot with Peach, and this kind of stuff happens a lot.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
What's with, burning, like, your double jump when you float? Like, Muska does it a lot. I'm not too sure if, like, he has to always do it.
Can you go play your match? Oh, my God.
Oh, that weird tippy hitbox.
That happens. Can you go play your match with Tristan?
Yeah, strange angles. Yeah, I can do that.
Cool. And can you get Nick to come here?
Alright.
Oh, great roller. Oh, and the taunt! Dudes. Feeling himself. Muska feeling himself. Oh, great upbeat there. Actually gets the ledge. Alright.
Just joining you to watch the historic victory of Ace over Muska?
If he does, that'll be a bit of a shake up.
Bit of a shock to the system for Muska. He was fresh off a good performance at my house, taking around about 0 games from my loss.
It's no 50. Oh, man. Okay, so Ace is just kind of getting, like, messed up really bad now. He, like, he saw the light at the end of the tunnel but got blinded, you know?
Yeah.
Oh, how did he land in time to get the power shield?
I still believe in it, though.
Me too.
He needs to keep composure. Musket will just dash attack if you start dash dancing every time. And it's like deceptively hard to learn to dash dance. It's like the most annoying thing to be hit by as well.
Yeah, it's like, and it anti-airs really well.
Yeah, especially like, against Marth. Like, not many things beat Marth coming down because he has a sword. But dash attack just seems to beat it.
It's really annoying, actually. It's just like, why is this happening to me? Kind of thing, kind of move.
Yeah.
So, game DOS.
Yep.
Musket one game up.
Back to FD. Good choice. I think Musket's alright on the stage, but Ace was doing a pretty good
job. Ace is better.
Yeah.
Oh, actually, that was a really good recovery. Because most of the time, Musket likes to chill, likes to have a lot of hang time on his recovery, but he just went like super quick dead to the ground, and Ace was looking for that.
So Ace got called out by the. When you like go to text Chase Peach and she just wiggles out and stands up. It's the worst.
Yeah, that'll happen. It's just. It's really obnoxious, actually. And he's throwing these turnips, man. He's pulling and throwing. I haven't seen Musket pull this many turnips in a while. I don't know. I feel like Musket can be a bit lazy with his turnip pulls, especially in this matchup when you really need them.
You mean lazy about how often he pulls? Or
yeah.
Lazy about, like, when?
How often.
Yeah.
Because I think when he pulls it, it's actually not too bad.
He's often a little bit obvious. He'll, like, run very clearly to, like, a corner and do it.
Yeah. By the way, stream, how's the audio? Please let us know whether or not the game or... the microphone needs to go up or down.
Musket always leaves himself vulnerable for Tibba in that situation.
Oh no! Didn't even go for the sweet spot. Now Ace is just left swinging at nothing.
Alright, so Ace trying to play the like outside dash dance game, trying to outspace most of his turnips, and Musket just kind of overcommits inwards.
Oh, that was actually...
Yeah,
that was weird.
He got him with the Musket flowchart, but Musket didn't expect him to get hit, so he went for the early down air.
Yeah. Man, Musket's really making this first stock last a really long time.
It's really demoralizing when you play against the Peach, they just live forever.
Another. Even the crowd's cheering for Ace, and he's just getting whooped. Oh no!
Wow,
oh
bad
no!
Guy.
Oh no!
Let's get Ace. Yeah, none of his moves are really strong right now. Musket's gonna go for the.
Oh my god! Yeah. That was so obvious. Like he could have just grabbed the ledge there. Oh no! Oh no! This is a train wreck, dude.
It's getting hit, dude. It started so well.
It really did, and now what's this up B? Oh no!
Let's go.
Ace, come on.
If he'd rolled up there, I think he would kill him.
Possibly, yeah. Oh my god, that stuck lasted for so long. Oh no. Yeah, this is
really stepping it up here, actually.
On. Good. This game's got it all, man. I'm loving this. This is so good.
Yeah, he's getting kind of whooped right now.
He's getting whooped so hard. Oh man, this started out so well for him, and now Musket's actually just crunching him. Gosh.
So you can always down tilt Peach out of that recovery.
Yeah, if you stand at the right spot and you get that.
I mean, you know, at this point he's got to go for some reads. I would have preferred if he'd waited to like confirm that read, but
yeah.
You know.
Zanbot needs to stop kicking people for emotes. It's really annoying. I don't know how to stop him. He's uncontrollable.
Yeah.
I'll unban.
The power has definitely gone to Zanbot's head.
Yeah. It's like an insta ban though, so you can join like rejoin. Oh man!
All right, so that was pretty one sided after all.
It was. It really was.
This is fun.
It was 5 emotes actually. Little Hallie. That's a
yeah. 4 would have been fine to be honest.
All right. I think am I? Who's next?
Ooh, Gorilla Boy Flores.
Either or, really.
Yeah, we'll play.
Okay. So you guys get to hear my lovely voice for a little bit longer. So we're gonna have Florets and Gorilla Boy up on the stream next. So Ace and Caleb going to be playing off stream. Naruvia Tristan is also happening. And next on stream will be me and Musket as well. That was a funny game, dude.
Yep. I was definitely nervous that first game. I was
super
like
super funny.
So I've got a system now. I just keep the controller in my pocket. No more losing it. Mind blowing.
I don't know how you
It's because, like...
I
never lost it. Then there was a period where I, like, didn't commentate at all. And then, like, recently I started actually, like... Because, I don't know, we had people like Donut and Shaky that would turn up and would just, like, commentate.
Kai's voice stands again.
Huh?
Yeah, Kai's voice stands again. Good as did. Okay, so jungle... Gorilla Boy.
Oh, is Milo Ace being played?
Yeah, dude.
That should be pretty interesting.
Yeah, will be. Actually, and Floyrats. And...
So getting a sense of deja vu here, we commentated this Friday.
Did we?
Yep.
I guess we did. Deja vu, I've been in this place before. I won the beat and I know it's my time to go. Alright.
Because we're in a point right now where there's only really like four commentators and maybe Ruben.
Yep. No, Ruben's legit, dude. I love commentating with Ruben. He's so much fun.
Alright. So five commentators.
Count them.
Count
them.
But one's usually playing another match.
Nah, Milo Ace is not being streamed, guys. We are pretty over time.
So. We don't want to get kicked out. We don't want to have a situation where...
Yeah, basically we want to kind of be like in grand finals at like 10-ish. Like streaming grand finals at 10-ish. So that's where we're at the moment.
Don't want a situation where someone has to split.
Yeah. Well, it's not even that. It's just like, I got a lot of stuff to pack up.
Yeah, that's true.
A lot of stuff to pack
up.
So... Oh, a little early on the roll. That happens sometimes, you know?
Yeah.
Think you got it, but you don't.
Warming up, you're just getting used to the distances again.
Yeah, it's one of those things, you know, you just gotta keep. Yeah, just gotta get it. Oh, that DI was actually. He actually almost could have, like, got another fair with that DI. Yeah. Smart wait from further out there. Oh, he's gonna pick up the fair as well.
Yep. Yep. Perfect.
Yes! That is actually. Oh, no.
It was all optimal until that part.
What's going on? I just got hyped because he did the Falco edge guard, but with, like, shit.
Oh, okay, yeah.
It was so funny. He, like, did down air back air or whatever. It's pretty funny. And I don't know. I just like it when Floretz gets the reverse fair.
Oh, yeah.
It's really exciting to me.
And if you just go for a regular reverse fair without doing a down air, they can probably SDI in tech on stage.
Depends on what... Oh, my God. That was a sick back air. That was like... Wavelined off.
Yep.
Back air. Pretty nice. Nick wasn't ready for it. And...
Good air dodge. Everything else was just...
Dude, actually, Floretz is, spot dodging down smashing heaps.
Mm-hmm. He's getting that inner peach.
The inner peach.
The inner peach in all of us. You know, spaces are just... When their spot dodge shining...
Oh my God, Floretz movement looking pretty good at the moment. He's actually moving pretty fast, and Nick is getting a little stuck in his.
Yes, that's been a complaint of Jax for a while now.
He just slowly walked up and like forward tilted Nick's shield.
Yep.
Not optimal.
No.
At all. I think Floretz needs to use more needles in this matchup, to be honest. It's one of the things that I noticed when I was playing against ZXV is that ZXV just let him rip, just like pop, 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 all the needles, you know?
Yeah, definitely.
Like,
Jack.
I think that's such a big tool for Sheik, especially in this matchup, because you can really, like, deny a lot of position with him. But,
in my experience, Jack generally only uses needles after he's taken a stock or when he's playing a laser camping box.
He only really uses them like edge guarding, and he doesn't even use them like really aggressively on edge guarding.
Sure, I mean but as far as like charging up a bunch.
Oh,
like,
right.
Yeah,
right.
Like, and like, yeah, we use them edge guarding, like, but like he won't just camp the platforms at times and charge up needles or just like.
Oh, great! Just great empty hop there.
Throw up a diagonal needle. You get the 3%. You can just run off, get a fair or something. Maybe a grab.
A double. Two quick bumps.
But he's still keeping quite close.
Wave dashes back, grabs the shield, there we go. Got the needles. See, that's why it's good. You get that quick needle, you force him to have to recover again. Well, you got phantom by the first hit there. Yeah. That's funny.
That looks like some 64 hit lag. Where you just. Yeah.
Super long. Nice. Okay. So this is very.
It is.
Nice to see more people kind of challenge Nick a bit.
Yep. I mean,
the needles. No, you don't want to be doing those needles at close range.
That
was a great fair.
Now that does a fair. Nick would not be happy with that.
No, absolutely not. Alright. I think with all the percent lead at the moment, though, since we have the Sedgeguard, no, a little too early.
He's not covering the air dodge anywhere near. Like, he's just expecting...
I don't think many people are really air dodge backstage.
Well, yeah, but when, like, Sheik's that close, like, they're not going to up B, because, like, they're just going to get punished easily, so...
You could potentially... Oh, he needs it. Oh. If he had a shield drop fair there, that would be... Oh, no.
Oh, that's... Okay, just goes for safe.
Yeah. Reset situation. Alright, that's pretty even. Oh, no, that's it.
Yep, the ace.
The ace. Got him. Yeah, it'll happen. Happens to the best of us. Actually, while this is going on, I'm going to exercise this opportunity to go to the toilet before I set.
Oh, yeah. Ready? Go! So, game two. Jack keeping it very close last time, just falling a tiny bit short. I'm guessing Nick would have banned Yoshi's? Maybe Battlefield, who knows? That was very slick. Once she can't air dodge the stage and has to like up B, she's a pretty she's a sitting duck. It's a rough life. Of course, Dreamlight Durr. Every single Marth fan Dreamlight. Yeah, if you're not expecting it, it can definitely get you. Yeah, that's rough. That's definitely a rough situation to be, because now he's got a whole mountain to climb. If he could have gotten that reverse back into a fair, probably not, but... So, Jack always used Edge Guard, now Upper Marth, Ace, by just dropping down and putting out a back air, and Ace would always run into it, but Nick, definitely a smarter breed of Marths, not gonna fall for that, gonna work his way around the back air. Doing, say, a ledge hop there with your invincibility from the ledge to just stuff Marth as he's coming up with his up B, because... He can do the needle. He can do the needle edge guard, like needle gimp on Marth, but if Marth sweet spots with his up B, I don't think fair will cover it. Fair forward tilt, down tilt will hit Marth on the ledge, like as he's coming up with his up B if he doesn't space properly. But unless he can do something like a gimp and then immediately land and do a Marth killer, take the ledge. Quickly wave dash off, and edge hop. Ooh. Yeah, definitely looking like it was it, but Nick just getting off a little bit early. Well, Nick trying for some swag, but still manages up B in time. And, 2-0. That's what people generally expect was going to happen, but... Jack keeping it pretty close game one. Not quite as close game two, but it'll happen. Coming onto the mic is
Sometimes
Gorilla
I just
Boy.
Forget how to play melee,
Yeah?
Game one, I thought it was one of those times. I just forgot how to play. I don't even think Jack was playing...
Either you guys have an extra...
Extra controller. Can you have Kai's?
Wow. Kai went to the toilet. Do you not have one? Or do you have one?
I have one that I'm using.
Oh, okay. Well, yeah. I mean, don't give him that. Because I guess...
I suck, dude. That sucked. That was so bad.
Aww. We all have our bad games. Game one, me versus Ace, wasn't particularly great either. You get nervous. Game one, you need a bit of time to get into your groove.
How to play against a certain person, and then you play them in remember. But I was just
That one was real. That last one was real. Nick's still having his OHN flu.
Yeah, it'll be gone in, you know, the near future, I would assume.
It'll be gone just in time to get it again at DI Nub Day 2. Perfect. And then...
Oh, that last suck on game one was so bad.
Yeah.
That was so bad.
Yeah.
It was bad.
Yeah. The problem I said again, like, Ace and issue was that, and even, like, game two, I was doing a bit, like, I was just dash-tacking a neutral, whereas, like, the goal should be to throw out turnips to force Ace to do an unsafe approach or, like, a desperate approach, and then dash-tack that. Like, if I'm just dash-tacking in neutral, he's going to dash-dance and get a grab, whereas if I throw out a couple of turnips and he gets a bit desperate, tries approach, maybe an unsafe fair or dash-tack,
then... Soon, by the way, Kai? Mine,
Kai and me will be on... Wait, has Kai played his game yet?
Yeah, good. He has.
Okay, then, yeah.
Let's go. Kai Musket.
All right.
Let's go. I don't know how I don't lose games in South Australia. Every single game I should lose. It's just that, like, somehow I don't. Okay, we got AC10, very own Kaiser. Kaiser, if you will. No, the OHN flu is very real. We got Anthony Musket with his signature peach. And Kai with the aggressive Falco. No. Alright. We got Kaizmo against Anthony Musket. You wanna join me, Jack? Alright, I got Jack joining me in commentary. How you doing, dude?
Good. Can we put him down as young Seto Kaiba?
Sure.
No, I can't be fucked up with that.
Dude, game one was the spaghettiest spaghetti I've played in a long time.
Oh man, that was bad.
That was some of the worst melee I've ever played.
Yeah,
like, and like,
I realized
you as well. It was just terrible.
Yeah. I kind of attribute that to playing 64 all day, but like, it should never be that bad.
Nothing should ever be that bad. It's because
I'm sorry, stream, that you guys had to fucking deal with that shit.
The first 10 seconds was good. I did a good thing. I had an edge guard, and then I was like, I'm gonna roll 4 seconds too early.
Yeah, you rolled.
And after
like,
that, it was
way
like, no.
Early. That was a terrible. I've never seen anyone roll that early, and I play Ace on a regular basis.
Yeah, I don't know what it, yeah.
That was like, I thought you were rolling and to bait me into like wave dash back to ledge. But like, you didn't wave dash back. Oh.
Anyway, we're gonna see some good melee for a change.
Hopefully.
Do you know who's good that I haven't seen on stream yet? Puff Guy.
Puff Guy is good.
I'm the biggest Puff Guy fan right now.
People were like, apparently when he joined the community. Oh, that's
it was
right.
A bit of an SA Nick story, was he?
It wasn't so much...
Or a Florette story.
I don't think... I think it was him and his brother both playing, and Musket was talking to the brother, and he was playing Puff. Yeah, Musket was playing Puff, doing rest setups, yeah. And he was like, oh, I've never seen my brother do that. So I was like... Musket was like, oh, they can't be that good. But Puff Guy's good. I don't know what they were talking about. Alrighty. Not Gorilla Boy.
I think Puff Guy's playing Ace now. Are you going to bracket on you?
Yeah, he would be, I think.
I'm like very curious as to how that match goes, to be honest. It's pretty even, from what I can see. Actually, Ace got a good lead.
Okay.
Alright, Kai loves daring over their shield and then shielding behind them. Because Musket loves back air out of shield.
Yep.
But Musket stopped doing that because he knows Kai loves doing that, so... Kai can probably afford to do like an up tilt or something instead.
Yeah.
As... That exact same situation happened when we were on commentary last tournament.
Yeah, exact same situation.
And
but I didn't notice
anything.
Because I was so tired. That's not consistent.
Can we just have Kaiser?
No, we can't have that.
Alright, good edge guard. And Kai didn't burn his jump because he got hit out of the startup of his up here. So, unfortunately doesn't make use of it. Good air dodge in from Musket. Ooh, really risky now.
Yeah, Kai's just flinging himself in. Willingly, thinking, you know, Peach is at 100, no crouch cancel down smashes for me. Peach ledge options, not so good.
Yeah, not so good, and Musket's not really one to incorporate the more good technical
ones.
Yeah,
the, like, immediate air dodge one.
He's not like, patient like Amada as well. Like, Amada will kind of do, like, upbeat stalls or, like, double jump stalls.
Sit there.
I feel like tournament winner is quite good at high percent.
Yeah. Particularly on Dreamland, where you live forever anyway.
Oh, that was really good. Gets him in the weak back, yeah? Man, that is a... What are you doing, Kai? We're seeing some high-quality melees today.
Just like every time you come to this fucking SA stream. Dude.
Yeah. I love dropping on down with a down air from the health platform, and it's not that good.
It's good. It's real good until the other guy knows you're about to do it, and then it's real bad.
Yeah.
Then all of a sudden you get down smashed for 50. You're in this good turn of pull. Clutch.
Toad pull. Yeah. Yeah, Musket's getting pooped up with his combos, though.
Yeah. Definitely dying under 100 on Dreamland on a regular basis.
Yeah. Remember the time I force dunked Musket on Dreamland with Apia? I never forget that moment.
Is that at the laggy fucking tournament?
Yeah. No, I don't think so. It was
at, that the one after?
It was at SAFGC.
Yeah, there was one we played on an LCD for some reason.
Oh, we did play an LCD, yeah.
I think that was that one.
Who knows? Whatever, Musket plays. That's Musket's home ground.
Yeah, that is definitely Musket's home ground.
Lol. Good judgment from Kai. I thought he was going to make it on stage.
Nah.
Kai's Mo takes game one. Anthony Musket's going to have to do a little bit of soul searching. Who's Euro tripping?
Who do you think Euro tripping
is? Is it Euro?
Yeah. If it's not.
I thought Euro was lead span 999 on the line.
Oh, well. Now I'm very confused if that's the case. That or he has multiple accounts.
Nah. I reckon it's just a secret follower of the South Australian scene.
Yeah. Sure. Whatever you want to believe, dude.
Alright.
Getting hit by Peach down, it always sucks. It feels like you should have had a hitbox there to stop it.
Someone's Twitch, for sure. I don't know whose it is, but it's definitely someone's. It's Euro Tripping's Twitch.
Yeah.
So, going back to Dreamland, Kai always wins here, doesn't he?
I feel like whoever wins the set wins here. Which, the recent time, has been Kai. But, you know.
Yeah.
I feel like Musket should be taking him to Fountain, though.
Fountain or FD? Kai's not that good on FD. Oh, it's Euro, the original speedster. The fastest moth on the planet.
Faster than Gorilla Boy? Damn.
He's way faster than me, dude.
Good to know.
I'm nowhere near as fast as Eurodriven. But he's fast without actually moving anywhere.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
He's fast on the spot. He's playing Dance Dance Revolution.
Oh, he's got the Salt Shaker Dash Dance going on?
Yeah, exactly. Yep, predictable air dodge. Yeah. So I noticed Musket will do an air dodge in, like, if certain conditions are met. And it's not necessarily the forwards backwards one, but, like, if he'll, like, let go of his... If he's floating to the edge, he'll, like, let go of his float well in advance if he's going to do an air dodge. And if he lets go of his float, he'll never do an attack.
Yeah, exactly. He likes his float cancels, which, I mean...
They're good.
Yeah. Sometimes you just gotta come down.
That was pretty sketchy.
Yeah.
Oh, Kai with the 2007 pressure. 2005 pressure.
Hey, sometimes you can get away with that. Sometimes people like shielding. Way too much.
Well, the advantage of 2005 pressure is that it's not evident that it's going to be bad pressure until after you've already done it.
Yeah, exactly.
That was really good. Ooh. Kind of risky to go for the bear, but he manages to get it. But this is going to be an edge guard.
Yep. Always weird watching the turn up four with the other guy. They get hit by it.
Yeah, Muska gets hit by that too often.
Throw all the lasers.
I feel like DIing up on the lasers is really good.
So SDIing? Yeah.
Yeah, I always just go straight up with Muff. Kai never hits me.
Good to know.
Whereas Kai, Muska seems to always go horizontally set up perfectly for the down air.
Ooh. Ooh. And here I was thinking that he would have been fountained five times there. The more you know.
Alright, so Kai is under control right now, but Muska
will probably take a while to die on Dreamland, and Kai won't.
Let's get down air again.
Yeah.
Yeah, that ouch.
Oh, really good choice, actually. Just up air him. Just do it. Should have just done it. I would have done it. Oh. But, you know, you can. There's a lot of ways to win in this game.
There are definitely a lot of ways to win.
Kaizmo takes it. All right, Anthony Musket, probably going to go back to the Musket household and... have a little bit of a think. Have a little bit of practice with Catherine's Falco.
Catherine's Falco is not that good.
It's not as good as Kai's, but you know.
It definitely will not suffice as practice.
I know. Alright, so we got someone else on stream now.
Ooh. Anthony Musket.
Bumped down
Mr.
from
Moosecat the once again, up against Neruvia.
Such a rude awakening when you go from the big leagues playing against Kaiser and winners semis. So you're playing the lowly Neruvia.
Wow.
In the loser's bracket.
Man, I'm going to have to play Ace or Puff Guy. I'm screwed.
Puff Guy will wreck you.
The Ace already beat him.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Thank fuck.
No, Ace, yeah, you can probably beat Ace. What? Alright.
Well, this is certainly the change of events.
Survival!
Alright, so button checks. Gorilla Boy's got new controller straight from somewhere in Africa. Because he left his last one in Sydney, so he's gotta make sure it chill drops and all that. And Kai just likes pressing buttons. So if the last couple of sets between these two are anything to go by, Gorilla Boy is probably going to take a 3-0, but he was not looking good against me earlier today. So, who knows what's going to happen. Alright, Battlefield. Oh, dash chancing for no real stage position at all. Yep. Good re-grab. Oh. Don't know what that up smash was though. Probably shut up, I bet. Nick with the claw, sometimes too fast on the triggers. I don't mind the air dodge. Though it's not gonna work out of it. Sometimes when you're the bird, you just die. Okay, I just hit you with the sword, don't come back, and that's stock, so. Power up by one. Pick up by one. Hi. Bring it back. That was a really slick glitch. Should have tried to refresh it, but doesn't risk it, just rolls up. Now, moving out with another big combo. Quick 50. Sometimes it's the fact that you just screwed. Although it's starting to warm up by the looks of things. At the very least. I'm playing Kai. Sorry, stream. didn't get the proper flu from OGN, but definitely not feeling 100%. That doesn't matter. Back air out shield. Yep. That is really good in that situation. Even if you meteor cancel it, there's nothing you can do as Falco. Look at the re-grabs. Even Nair was clean. Oh, flip around the bugger. Bullet. A little bit slow on that back end. Might cost him. Yeah. Snick back on, that's not what you want. No DI on full throw. Good angle though. Really good tech. It's not gonna matter in the long run, but it looked real cool. Oh, will it matter? No. I'll go from Kai. Nick takes game one.
Ready? Go!
Interesting pick. Usually, Falcos are afraid of being killed immediately here, but I guess his plan is to smother Nick with pressure. Just combo him just as hard back. Good back air. Good read on the up B. Knew he wasn't gonna stall, just killed him for it. See you later. Getting grabbed on that platform is not a problem, Falco. Oh, pressure. Triple spot dodge. If you know someone's playing bad, stuff like that can really help you out. That was a really good DI from Nick on the down air, made sure he was on the other side of it. Kai catching a rake there. Nick thinking he could just hit L. Wasn't the case. If you're unsure, just press A. It'll do the same thing, but might hit him. Big tipping, guys. Go on. Two stock space. Guys, just gonna get hit the sword at the moment. Good up B from Kai. Everyone expects you to go to the cloud, so going straight at the stage is actually a pretty good idea. Nick managed to cover it, but the intention was a lot better than going straight up, which is really easy to cover. Crouch cuts a down smash. Lands from Kai, cloud for free, and that's it. Yeah. Alright. Game two. Goes to Nick. Alright, going back. I assume Kai's plan is to just hit him as hard as Nick's hitting him. That's the real benefit you get of Yoshi, you don't have to hit Mark that hard to kill him. Yeah. Stop over. Can't up be that close to the stage. Expect not to get encountered. Kai getting angry at his inability to press buttons. Nick reading everything right now though. Yeah. Dreamland Nick didn't help Kai out in the last set they played, so I think he wants to try the small space, seeing as the big space definitely was not helping him at all. It's probably going worse than the Battlefield games were. So it's worth a shot. Denkai thinks he can win the grands at the losers final, so... Yeah. It's not looking good for Kai right now. Put the eye on the up tilt at least. An up tilt. Can we get a stop? Hey. Ooh, big tipper. You're dead either way at that point of Yoshi's, but getting hit by a tipper like that never helps your self-esteem going into the next game. Well, the next set, I guess, for Kai. Ooh, Rick just jumps out. Not guaranteed. Kai, really good pressure. Corner pressure there. Eventually forced Nick into a situation he didn't want to be in and took the stock for it. 3% blazes, yeah. Yeah, good grab. And that's gonna be the set. Ready, 3-0 to Gorilla Boy.
Alright, so we got Ace against Floratz.
And I am playing real stupid.
You're also getting stuck in your shine every single
yeah,
time.
Yeah, that was so lame, dude. That was actually the lamest.
It happens.
And this is our loser's quarters.
So we got Ace, who's always capable of making an upset, but never favored to, really.
Yeah. I that's a really good way to put it, actually.
I guess that's what an upset is.
Yeah. Well, I don't know, but when he beats people with... Can we really call it an upset at this point?
Yeah, I mean...
Yeah.
It doesn't happen often, but every now and then... Like, when you think you've forgotten about Ace and that Ace is never gonna, you know, really make his mark again, he'll just take a set off someone, you know, decent.
Yeah.
He's just, like, a really... He's gotten way better at, like, waiting, like, and just occupying good positions, I would say. He doesn't really do anything fast, but, he uses that nice long dash dance and, nice long sword.
Pretty much.
Could have probably done a lot better out of that if he'd taken the ledge.
Oh, that down smash was super legit.
Nice.
Down smash is good sometimes when like you're trying to catch people falling down because like makes shit go so low. The hitbox, it's just nothing but hitboxes above it.
Yeah.
Oh, that F smash almost hit, actually. Maybe if he was a little faster, I'm not sure.
God, oh. Get triangle jump.
Dude, the triangle jump is actually like my favorite, like, flub of melee.
Dude, I use, like, downward air dodge a lot.
Well, it...
Like, diagonal air dodge from the ledge sometimes.
Oh, yeah, but that's because you want to get some involved.
Yeah, I'm trying to get... It's a triangle jump, dude. That's what it is.
Tell Flip if you're needle more neutral.
Yeah, I agree. He needs to, like, kind of platform the needle. Who is Lagrange CL? Or Lagrange CL?
He's a Sydney guy, I think.
I feel like he's in every single stream.
Yeah, me too. He's either Sydney or Queensland. don't know. Actually, I have no idea, honestly. I think he's a PM person, to be honest.
He's in every stream and he knows all the players.
It's great. It's exactly what... More people need to be like Lagrange. Honestly. Just watch every stream.
Lagrange. It's Lagrange to me, I don't know what he's looking at. It's French.
Lagrange. Forget.
Oh, he's swinging real hard. Yeah. I'm not supposed to do that.
Yeah, Chick's hitboxes are way too quick to, like, be doing that.
Oh, no. Rex, no.
How did he go so... What? Do you see that? He, like, stuck to the top of the wall for a bit. Like, he continued to ascend even though he, like, bopped his head. It was weird. Alright. This game's weird sometimes. I guess he hit, like, the not-ceiling bit of it.
Oh, good read. Read the flood dodge.
Good stuff. Alright, crowd's cheering for Marth.
I'm cheering for Marth. No. Oh, God. Nutty.
Okay. Not much to say about that, to be honest. Francis.
I bet it's Dorsey.
No. Definitely isn't.
Or Rainbow.
No, Rainbow is just like Rainbow and then like five numbers.
I can see Rainbow having like a second Twitch account just for stream monstering.
Because he doesn't want to be called out. He doesn't want to be like, oh, look, RJ's watching.
Getting the download. Maybe it's RCG.
Nah.
I guess we'll never know.
I don't think it's like a Fisherman Joe scenario. I think that Lagrange is just a big Australian streamer.
Oh, that's nice. A roll. Why do people roll when they tech on the platform like that? You do it all the time as well. I don't get it.
Sometimes you have to mix it up.
Yeah, but it's like, it happens all the time. And I'm like, rolling never seems good when you're on a platform above Marth.
I think it has its place, but I think by itself it's not good, obviously.
Yeah.
But it's like, tech in place, or try and edge slip and then fail.
Yeah.
And then, or just no tech. Like, you don't really have a lot of options against Marth.
Above Marth, you just want to be shielding, though. Like, if you're buffering a roll, it means you're not shielding. That's my opinion.
Yeah, I always can't shield in time half of time.
I always think it's quite nice when they roll against me, because if they get the chance to roll, it means I've already missed my tech chase, and it just gives me more time to set up something else.
That's a fair way to look at it. Oh my god, dude. So Aces actually pull it ahead this game.
Yeah, agreed. I respect that kind of greed, because I think down tilt would have been better there, but like, Sheiks do often kind of bob their head up above the stage when they double jump.
Oh my god, that combo?
And holding in will get killed.
Ace was in control for so long.
Oh no, what a read. What a read. Dude, he's reading everything right now. Floret's not doing anything, but if he did do something, it'd be red.
Is that back always, throw?
Yeah, it's back throw. And every time we'll double them. So you just do a full hop back air and it kills them. So if you did a full hop back air,
that's
killed.
Two chain SDs for the flare rats now. Kind of sucks, to be honest.
Nah, I'm keen to have a close game though. I mean, Ace's lost stuck me as well with an SD. He just kind of got like jabbed it down to the edge a bunch of times. Yep. Oh no, Ace. Oh no. Good dash dance. Obviously hasn't given up yet. Floretz does the Floretz, which is the air dodge on stage to down smash.
It's pretty legit sometimes, dude.
It works, dude. It gets me all the time.
It's so strong.
Ooh, that man. Yeah. No, he was perfectly placed to get the kill there as well. The Ace, I know, would have got the kill. And Ace is doing pretty good here.
He is. He's actually evened it up pretty well. Doing pretty well for him.
He's actually grabbing Floretz really well. He's just like dash dancing in the right spots.
Yeah.
Oh, look at this patient play.
Oh my god.
Floretz, what are you doing? Grab? No. Grab. Please grab. Alright. Jesus to grab when she gets running along the ground towards him.
Down smash every day.
Yeah. Unfortunately, at low percent. Going early is not much of a mix-up.
Yeah. Well, I'll skip Floretz again.
Well, for those of you in the chat who haven't seen this, this is a storied rivalry.
Don't do it.
These guys play doubles together? They're very much like the Norwalk of South Australia.
That's a good one. That's actually the best call I've heard about these guys.
Yeah. Catherine, of course, being the Alex 19.
That's amazing.
Alright, we might just start straight off. No, we
nah, hand warmies. That's my, my friend's over there. I don't like it matters, because I have a computer here.
And, Flores had a pretty good run in SA recently, getting second on the second most recent PR. But at the moment, Musket is looking like the mango of these two.
Are they just starting? Yep. Looks like it. Okie dokie.
Wow, Musket with the movement, but unfortunately all of his attacks like clip the platform.
Yeah. Oh, yes.
That's so good.
Oh my god, he's just getting it. Well, yeah. To be honest, he just kind of slowly made Musket descend.
I mean, yeah, but he's racking up percent. I mean, consider it a combo, right?
Yeah. Eh, it works.
Lol. I love when you get hit by Musket's, like, long descending forward air from, like, way downtown. It is still really stupid. And, like, obviously, you both know that it's a mix-up, but you still feel real dumb because he just literally went held forward for, like, several character legs and hit forward air. Alright, so I think back air is really good in this matchup from Sheik. It's one of her main ways of out-prioritizing Peach. Peach generally has the best hitbox.
Oh my god. That was actually really good by Musket for once. Like, Flareon is really always, almost always, getting back to stage, like, ledge hop aerial.
Yeah, he loves to do the little, like, stalling fares, and they're not really safe.
And he also likes to, like, drop off the stage and go for an aerial, which is super duper risky, but he pops it in there, like, all the time.
It's pretty good, though, I mean.
It's good, but it's, like, really risky.
You come back on with, like, Sheik's biggest hitbox, and also you kind of bait them into, like, chasing you. Peach King does it all the time. That's why I think it's good. Even though he does a bunch of bad stuff, I suppose. But, you know. Everything in this game is risky if you get called out for it. And that's like a pretty unusual thing to call out, I would say.
Yeah, okay. That's fair enough.
But you do get punished a little bit harder if you do get called out. Kind of like double A's from the ledge.
Yeah. This has been really even, actually, so far.
These two both bring in their A games, I presume. Haven't really been watching.
Rinse and repeat, Musket takes it.
Good choice with the yeah, knowing that Flores can tech the down smash if he went for it.
Almost got that that low up air hitbox. I was hoping for it. I want to see that one again, like someday.
Yeah.
It's like a. It's like an urban legend. People talk about it. You never really see it.
I don't actually believe that hitbox exists.
Oh my god!
Shine Spike from
Holy Florets. Moly! You got Shine Spike from Standard Sage.
Yeah.
Oh man. This is an incredible fair. Florets fairs can be really clutch. Oh no. That was not a good risk reward assessment.
Pretty Florets. Good, like, over triforce type recovery. Like,
Oh, another one.
That was Dude. So good.
Oh my god, Florets is amazing. Florets is so
I didn't think that was gonna work, because I thought he was too invincible. But he managed to make it pop off the, like, explosion. Unfortunately, this Rinse Repeat's edge guard has given Musket time to,
Pull a stitch. Pull a stitch. I mean...
He wasted it.
Yeah, here he did. So, all things considered, not too bad for Florets, but he's still, like, even. That recovery was amazing.
Yeah. It's always nice when you see Australians such do good things.
Well, we gotta be known for something, I guess. It's like, oh, remember that one time you recovered that one way, and then get down smashed, cash cash and down smashed a bunch by a Peach. That's what we're gonna be known for.
One day Cal will pull off that recovery against Musket.
And I'll just go down in history. Dude. If Cal like
I actually really want to see a Musky Cal Salty Sweet animation.
If Cal comes to SA, for sure. For sure, dude.
And Musket's Cal's a big gambler, you know? He put $50 on the line against Miles. He's not afraid.
Yeah. Oh no.
Oh, it's never safe to jab.
Yeah, apparently not. Wow. Somehow Floret's actually cleaned that up. He like stole that. Interesting.
Oh. Alright. So this doesn't usually happen. Usually Musket is pretty clean beating Florets.
Yeah.
Last time in fact Musket went Fox against Florets and managed to win.
I think Musket's Fox isn't too bad against particular matchups.
I think it's better than Skrattel's.
Didn't he like beat him in Fox series at some point?
Wouldn't be surprised. Just in like matchup spread and understanding of the game, like his like Fox specifically isn't necessarily better than Skrattel's, but like playing against his Fox is harder because Musket obviously knows how to play the game. And Florets is it's getting old. Florets, pull out a new trick, please.
Oh, oh no!
So that was a bait. He could have just killed Musket there, I think. He could have done a sick reverse fair. Musket had no chance.
I think he's a bit too close to the ledge.
Oh, it's over. Oh, reverse fair again, dude.
He's not ready for it.
My Fox main instincts are telling me like shine, which obviously converts to reverse fair. Obviously, I'm not a Fox main either.
Oh, he has a bomb.
Oh, he's gonna explode. It's like you gotta rush it down when they get the bomb.
Oh my god!
It's over.
He still has the bomb. Oh.
Nice roll.
Man, everyone in SA has been popping rolls lately, me included. We've all just been rolling heaps.
Yeah, I don't know what it is.
It's something in the air.
You're all scared. So much fear in SA.
That's two stitches and a bomb. And there's a new trick. That shield pressure is pretty legit.
We must get using the RNG manipulation very well this game.
Another tech on platform. Yeah.
Alright, what's he gonna do? Yeah. That's tough, that's really hard recovery. But helps him a bit higher.
Oh, nice. There we go. That's the chic stuff I want to see more out of Florets. Popping needles, dude. Florets getting heaps of shield grabs. And also getting down smashed a lot.
Yeah, the Musket of old, you could always shield grab. Recently, he's been kind of picking it up. But apparently, Florets knows his times when he can shield grab.
Oh, another one!
Wow. Neither of these characters getting punished at all for just throwing out down smash.
Well,
it's really hard, but like you gotta do it.
Yeah, it is hard. You gotta. I definitely spend time just be like, alright, wave dash out of shield, shine or something.
There's another stitch, by the way.
Really?
Yeah.
Three stitches and a bomb. Keep track. Wow. Florets got a good combo there. Oh no.
Wow, Florets was forced off to two down, but a moment ago.
Monster stuck for him. Oh no, he doesn't go to the ledge.
Get a choke there.
Florets is just feeding off of all this choke coming out from Musket.
This is not the finest performance I've seen from Musket.
Nah. He's a bit lazy there, just like full turn up throw, full turn up throw.
Every time, it's so good.
As long as it's not a stitch, I guess. Or unless it loses stitch property after you hit it.
I think it does. I imagine it would.
Just don't hit the bomb.
That was a stitch.
No way.
It was totally a stitch.
No way.
Trust me, dude.
I'll have to check the tape. Someone in the stream, please confirm whether or not that was a stitch.
Alright, we got a tight battle here.
Oh, actually, like that chance was sick.
Musket is sometimes hard to hit in the neutral. That's one thing that's like always in the past not been the case. But I was playing him yesterday and sometimes it was just hard to hit. And I was like,
comes down really easy.
Alright, one back air will probably do it, but.
Yeah, that edge is always coming.
Yeah. It's the safest thing. It's a level 1 thing, but still gotta read it.
Yeah. Oh, no fair. That's gonna do it. Ferrets and lose this finals.
Alrighty.
First time in a while.
Well, good luck. Try it.
Thank you.
We got Flareth against Kai. Yeah. And joining me will be Ruben. Rubeezy. The Rubster. The Rube, if you will.
Hey, dude. Did you see the guy from California?
Which guy?
Because, I don't know, he's like Asian.
Is he good?
No. He's just from California. He's on an internship. Here.
Why isn't he good? He's from California, right?
Yeah.
He plays Melee and he's from California. You're not making any sense, Ruben.
But well, there was a guy from California here.
Yeah, and he's not good at Melee.
And he's not good at Melee. But he plays Melee.
He plays Melee and he's from California. This is actually blowing my mind right now.
I know, he seemed like a nice guy to me.
I'm sure give him like a couple of hours to warm up and he'll be like much better than all of us. Did you see that American dude that came to the Melbourne Arcadian?
Oh yeah, like shouldn't we have this in like proper
shit?
Oh,
they're playing.
Yeah,
they're holy moly, I thought this was like some sick hand moments. Alright, let's play some games. Loses finals.
Dude, Blackjack's your favourite Melbourne player, though.
Blackjack, yeah, he's up there. Blackjack, Forte.
Oh, that was a sick bet.
Kai dips real low to make Florets with the edge guard, but unfortunately it was a little too low.
Oh, no.
Oh, Shine, no, it doesn't get the run. Unfortunate.
I feel like I've seen a Shay get an edge guard like a million times by now.
Yeah.
Yep.
They'll do it.
Just like same way. Oh, guesses the no tech. But he does tech. Yeah.
Kai could have just shined him there.
Oh, yeah, that's it. Nice, that's it. Nice.
Good coverage, actually.
Real good coverage.
I don't know if he reacted or like he just knew. Probably reacted.
Or it was just a random F2 that shakes it up.
It was a flop.
Yeah.
Oh, that is good. No, no.
Can't finish the job. That'd have been real good.
It's a good idea.
Yeah.
I think Kai got his jump back or something, did he? No, maybe not.
I don't know. I don't think he did. I just think Flareth needed one more hit and he didn't get it.
Good now. That was so good.
Nice.
Doesn't get his angle, unfortunately. Backhand should really cover that, but if you're a little bit imprecise in the backhand, will.
That smash seems so.
That was actually the simplest edge.
Yeah, that was just like a clean backhand. You just like. I don't know.
You could not be missing that edge guard. Jack doesn't deserve to win.
If Jack loses now, he 100% deserves it.
Yeah, that was... That was like Sheik's baby's best edge guard. I mean, we all miss those things every now and then. We all flub wave dashes, we all miss whatever else. This wasn't ready for the opportunity.
Really shouldn't be.
That was weird. He like down aired his shield.
Oh no. Oh no.
Oh my goodness.
I think that was a flop.
Yeah, good chance for the back air. Good pressure. Down tilt. Do you reckon down tilt would kill? I reckon it would. No!
Oh.
Kaiser!
Oh, Jesus.
What is happening?
This game.
This is terrible.
So many missed edge guards.
Alright, try it again.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
Gets a forward air? I thought it was gonna like.
Oh!
Why was that
a forward air? Yeah. Kai bemoaning the fact that he got a forward air instead of a nair. These things happen in life.
Like, that missed back air from.
Yeah, I mean, at the end of the day, Kai got a couple extra lives there. So, can't be too unhappy, although I know he will be. Guy trying to muscle his way out of the corner with down airs, but Borat's still managing to keep center decently well.
Sick power shoot. Oh, I love getting both hits of the down tilt. I mean, fucking up tilt.
Yeah. It's like really safe, good on shield. It only loses to like crowd cancel or like doing something in between the hits. Just a good move.
Oh yeah.
Alright, Kai's moving now.
Get to the ledge. Shit.
Oh, the roll shine. What a combo.
So
Kai's game plan seems to be like positioning himself above Sheik and like going for down airs with shield drops. Seems to be working alright. Because Jack's like game plan generally against Falco is to like try and tank the laser or shield it to like do a nair at a shield or a forward tilt.
Yeah.
So if you like change up the angles and opt for mostly like high down airs, then you can really mess with Jack. And Sheik doesn't have the best like upward zip options. So.
Dude, lasers from platforms actually amazing.
Dude, like when you fall from the top platform with a
laser, that's
it just
I mean,
kills
dash
dance. He just like puts him in the corner.
It's so good.
Yeah. Because everyone wants to dash dance because they're like, he's gonna down air. And so they dash dance all the way to the side. And you come down with a laser and then he's in the corner. Obviously there's counterplay, but it's hard.
Yeah, you have to like pull it out. Oh, damn.
Yeah. Bad read.
Get off attacks, spoiling that.
Kind of moving and grooving, but it really is the right moment to go for that wavelength shenanigans. Floretz is a little bit too close.
Nice. Nice combo for Floretz. Simple shit stuff.
I hope Kai wins. I like playing Kai more.
Oh, have you played Kai today?
Yeah, it was, he played really bad. It was very one-sided. Yes.
In the game 2 with Muska was pretty close, but like he pulled 2 stitches to bomb, so
alright. Doesn't quite get the arms attack. Gets the
slide off.
Yeah, it's a neutral attack.
Yeah.
Flare's always gonna land in that situation with an aerial. Kinda like you, Ruben. You always wanna land on the platform with an aerial.
Well, like fuck. Sick platform kids.
Ooh, Kai with all the control. Flareth's gonna like retreat to the ledge and try and camp, but ooh, up air doesn't quite make it. I think Kai could have jumped a little bit higher there. Gets a stray back air. Catches Flareth on the platform. Might have been a shield poke, not sure. And that'll be 1-1. Change the player cam tags. Alright, Kai obviously not fully in the zone. Giving me directions on how to operate the stream. Ready? What's up, Quetz? Do you know I'm housing with Quetz?
Oh, yeah.
I have the best housing situation.
Oh, yeah,
it's
tell
so
me about
good.
It.
I'm housing with Quetz, MacD, and Zoo. And MacD and Zoo's friend, who I don't know. But I'm actually so psyched.
That's pretty sick.
Quetz is just a homie, man. Ever since Zeal 2014.
What's Zeal?
Very easy to get along with, man. Zeal was the tournament I went to in 2020. And that was
that was a sick Shorten and not so sick recovery.
It's a bit Shorten and Bane's flare adds into being really bad.
Nah, Quet seems like a nice guy. I think I money matched him at BAM or something.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, you're picking up more SA people. That's unfortunate. Yeah, I don't know, I just chose the cheapest flight. I would have assumed that the other SA guys would have chosen the cheapest flight as well, so.
Yeah,
I remember talking to Quetz at Zeal about how everyone in Perth just played PM, and he was saying, you know, Nick, I'm gonna try and get Perth to play Melee, because Melee's sick and it's having a bit of a revival. And lo and behold, now Perth, arguably one of the strongest states in Melee, arguably the strongest with Scud.
Language CL.
Lag range?
I don't know, but he knows. He knows Kai gets triggered by those Twitch chat. advice.
Yeah. Well, Lagrange would know, because he's in every single stream I've ever seen.
He is, I do see him a lot.
He's just around, he's a man about Twitch. Oh, good, like, safe pressure, okay? Oh, good read! And gets to sit down
and... Oh, another one? Oh, yeah, he couldn't get the last one.
Yeah, he couldn't get the follow-up because he landed on the platform and he didn't have any room to run. But, manages to seal it, so good stuff. Kai gets away with, like, shine to wave land on platforms a lot. I've never seen him ever get punished for it, except for by, like, my Falco.
Well, it's hard to punish, isn't it?
Just grab it. I mean, it depends on, like, what side you're on and all that stuff, but I think in an ideal world, that would always be shield drop punishing that. Dude, the South Australian scene is godlike. We have the best production quality, we have the best personalities, we got Ruben.
Straight up.
Straight up. Alright, so this is a pivotal match in the set, I would say. Ooh, just runs into Chief's arms with that grab, but gets 8% on it and nothing more. Gotta take the ledge there.
Yeah. I was gonna say. I mean, Flareon's got lucky with that shine.
Flareon's has gotten a couple of real lucky grabs and got like 2% on each
other.
Oh, gets double move. This is actually on a knife's edge. It's closer than it might appear. Oh, he could have grabbed the back throw again.
That's what I was thinking he was going to do. But no, he continues the combo.
Oh, looking like ZXV, but gets the sour spot. The perfect sour spot right there. Oh, he's DI out there.
Yeah.
Got a DI out. Kind of
LaGrange,
down
yeah. What state are you from?
Sydney? I don't know. So in that situation, Flareon's got a DI out. Or try and DI for like an ulti attack. Because I think that covers both the down air and the back air.
Alright.
The thing is, if they back at you and you don't get attack, you're dead anyway, so like, DI in is like pretty much useless. Since it was at like 150%.
Yeah. Liking these areas.
Yeah, she kind of a character that can just spam a lot of hitboxes.
The hitboxes are great.
Yeah, they're fast as well. Spam them.
Oh, what an angle. But still, Flareon still looked like he had control of that whole stock, so...
Yeah. I'm actually gonna go to the bathroom.
Alright, see you, dude.
So I'm in good shape for my set in a minute.
Oh shit, Ace is running out of the evac room to catch his train. He's fucked up. Alright. Good tech, Chase. I trust a down air out, but Flareon's being as good as he is, dash dance grabs it. Sounded like from the sound effect that she was gonna die off the top, but just exploded through the side. Flareon's turns around there. In power at least, I don't really see any like reason to turn around at that position. Look at this. When you left.
Yeah. Maybe the stream just died. Who knows?
Or maybe it did.
It's not all about you, Ruben.
No, I was saying it's about you, dude.
Nah, it's probably about you. If it was Kai taking over, I don't think they would have said that. Or maybe they would.
Nah, no. Alright, whatever.
Alright, so... Good guy. Whoa, what an up air. That was really good. He clean beat guys down there, that's impressive. It must have been the
that's
angle.
That's hard to
like,
do, yeah.
Because Falco has the least amount of disjoint right at like the direct angle, like of his foot kind of thing. So if he's like pointing directly at you, because the hitbox of down air like extends really far outside the air, like
yeah,
the sides,
yeah.
But not really far below. That's probably what happened. Because usually you would see that trade, I think.
How much does down air do, like in percent?
Decent amount. Well, like
because like I only did like 14. Nine. I don't know. It looked like it only did like 9 there.
Maybe Kai just said he might have got a weak hit, might have spam you too much, who knows. So yeah. Kai with an opportunity to close this out this stuff, but not much of an opportunity.
Yeah, Kai had like a opportunity before, but then like Flyrat's just
hit him.
Yeah, Flyrat's got like 100% on more like extra credit.
Oh, we got Sydney Smash 2 in the chat.
Sydney Smash 1
is busy watching Smash 4. Oh, probably watching like Mega or something.
Sydney Smash 2, is that like Fibsy or something?
Alright, so we got some loud exclamations happening from Kaizmo.
He's leaning back with a smile though.
We got
is this Luigi? Is it Luigi?
It's definitely Luigi.
It's a Luigi.
Alright, yahoo, indeed.
Luigi with like a chain grab between like 60 and 100 or something like that. Like 40 and 80.
This matchup's still good for Falco, so...
Yeah, I don't get how Luigi can move. Like, it's all about those wave dashes and the lasers just messing up.
And Florence is not the best at, like, not being put off by lasers. Yeah.
That was solid.
What a stop.
Oh.
That's the best move in the game, straight up. It just, I don't get it. It just, like, covers the whole screen. It's even
so
a priority.
Cool. It's so cool.
Recovery move. It's just everything. It's everything you want to move.
Oh no.
Oh, and Florad's looking like a third place finisher.
He's up. Oh yeah, this is the last game. Oh, reset. No.
You should have waited for him to land and then got the punish. But what are you gonna do?
Up B. Stronger when it's on the
ground.
On the ground. Yeah.
Ball.
No.
So.
No, dude. Oh, no.
This counterpick not quite working out for Jack. I think it would be safe to say.
The last time he got like a million misfires in Miko, but he hasn't even had the opportunity to side B, so that's probably it.
Kai's not letting him recover, he's just hitting with Dennis. Alright.
Yep.
He knows.
I love Luigi's sound effects.
This is really incredibly rough. Oh my goodness.
Gonna be
this is a massacre.
Nah.
Nah.
I felt like it could have worked for Flores, but like... It started incredibly bad. Oh.
Yeah, there it is. Flores special.
Yeah. Kai jumps out of it though.
Oh. Misfire. No. Yeah. Alright.
Yeah. Alright.
Unfortunate.
Good luck, dude.
For Florence. Wish me luck.
I did. Already.
Wish me luck again.
Good luck, dude. Alright. Jack. Do you want to commentate? Oh, cheers.
You gotta
knock
him down so the lasers don't get
him. What's up, man? I felt like that Luigi could have worked, but
I was gonna get beaten on FD by his Falco Sheik, regardless. So I figured the Luigi was worth a shot.
Yeah.
Just hit the zero button, dude.
Shit.
Yeah.
Alright, who's this? I guess it's still Kaizmo. Do I have to really type?
Yeah, just type
jungle gorilla mode.
Get most of jungle in, and it'll come up. There you go. It'll do that. Just put Gorilla Boy for the segment. Don't bother with the sponsor. Let's see if that works. Change Grant.
Oh, yeah, shit. Alright, Nick actually playing Marth in an SA tournament.
Well, International's coming next week, dude.
I know.
So he's got to practice. Apparently he's staying with him, so...
Oh, yeah, he's staying with, like, staying with Quetz, MacD, Zoo, and, like, MacD's friend. So, yeah, that'd be pretty...
How good is MacD's friend, do we know?
I don't know, he's been, like, travelling around, Dave. I think I saw him in, like,
He must be travelling if he's gone to bloody Australia.
Yeah, he's travelling heaps, I reckon, because I think I saw him on, like, a, what's it, like, Air 3 or whatever that...
Oh, the...
The one where Chuda took a game from Marta.
Yeah, the...
Yeah, I saw him commentating there.
UK tournament. So, big stuff.
Okay. So, he's travelling a bunch, and I know Quetz would be happy to have... MacD.
Yeah, exactly. Jungle is Gorilla Boy's sponsor. Like, Monkey Man picked him up a month ago. It's been working out well for him. I think it pays better than Nova, which is funny.
Yeah, it's pretty much just Nick and Garrett's inside joke that they've forced onto everyone.
It's a brilliant sponsor. I'm looking for it, dude. I want to be a part of the jungle. I don't know why you wouldn't want to be.
Yeah, I mean Garrett's fucking introduction video to the jungle.
Yeah, exactly.
Pretty good.
I think the big thing
but
jungle
Nick
needs
is getting fucking owned.
Yeah.
Holy shit, I didn't even realize. Last Lock Nick's actually good.
Yeah,
so
actually.
It's
real
so hard,
scary,
it's so hard to seal it against Nick.
Yeah.
It's the hardest part.
I don't think anyone's taken a game off Nick's mark. Like, obviously no one's played it, but like, no one's looked like beating it in a while.
Yeah.
Like, he played like trash against me. Still beat, you know, seemed to have me pretty clean.
Alright, nice. Good DI by Kurt. Can't get another follower. Kai would be getting frustrated by now, I reckon.
I don't think so. Now he is. That's the sort of thing that'll...
Alright. Kai focusing real hard. Oh, no.
He was all over that.
Jesus.
Nick will just sometimes go for that. Like, he'll go for the reaction tech, Jesus. Well, he wanted the crouch cancel down there. Did he get it? Ooh, that's
oh, yeah.
Good.
He's out of crouch cancel set now. Oh. Jumps out. Oh, what was that?
I
Come
don't
Nick
know.
Knows. Nick knows. Yeah, Mark Killer. And
Kaisman Kai takes game one.
That could have been ugly for him.
If he had dropped that, it would have been the like fastest 3-0 after that.
Yeah, he could have got like the that free last stop. I mean, yeah. Alright, we're going back. Ready? Go!
Nick will kind of do this to you. Well, you take a game off him, and he's just like, nah, not again.
Yeah, I mean, like, when we were playing friendlies, Nick was winning all of them.
Yeah, well, you've always struggled a bit for Samus, so it kind of makes sense.
Oh, no, like, when... against, like, Kai.
Oh, yeah, well...
But I did win the last friendly before we signed up, so... I was happy about that. But, like, it was kind of like the same thing. I was up 3-6-1.
And almost then, brought it back.
And, yeah, then I, like, ended up winning with, like, 40% last stock. So, yeah. Ooh, what was that?
Kind of annoyed. Some description. I don't know what that was about.
Maybe he was meant to, like, come with a rising down here? Yeah. That's your problem. Yeah.
Ooh, he wanted to get around it real bad.
Yeah, that was so close.
You can tell.
Nice shot. It didn't look like it would hit, because like the back air shine's pretty small.
Yeah. They are a lot smaller than I think. There's only one in my second against Kai where I thought I was going to get hit. Press grab, just like, well, if I get the grab, I'll get hit regardless. I just whiffed. I was like, okay. Reverse fade in the battle.
Nice, Joey. That's really smart. But...
no DI.
Yeah, gotta... and he gets like that bad get up that you gotta... he clearly didn't want to see. But that happens. So. Kai's movement.
Kai is moving really well today.
Yeah.
Like, punish game, questionable. You know, been a few really good stocks by him, but. Regardless of that, it's punishment.
That first game against... I think you won it, but that first game was really sloppy by both of you.
Oh, yeah. When the one where I, like, fought him underneath Battlefield, like,
yeah. And you had, like, like a clean back air, and then you just, like, got the weak hit.
Yeah, I was just like, whoa. I had a lot of sloppy games. Played really well with that musket, though. Yeah. So.
Alright, we're at Yoshi's.
One good set.
Oh! Kaiju. Kaiju. Yeah.
You gotta read the clock. Fucking laser hit one of the shy guys off screen. That could be it. Yeah. Doesn't even attempt to side view.
Yeah. I don't know, maybe he thought he had a jump. I don't
know. That's true.
Nice power shoot.
What do you think of this pick against Nick? I hope the stream hears that.
I don't know, Marth's like such a big character on like a small, like a really small stage, so like Kai can like hit Nick real easy on this, I think.
Yeah, that's true, but Kai can get hit really easy on this too.
Yeah.
Just the trade off.
Yeah, Nick's punish game is really good, and those platforms he definitely takes advantage of, so.
Surprised that back air didn't hit.
That up smash actually reaches real high, but
yeah. It's one of those moves people forget.
Oh my god.
Ooh. That shield DI, Kai.
He's shaking his head.
Looking to make this kill pretty clean after that.
But Kai did manage to spike a flagger on his way to his death, so. I like
it. That's what he's looking like right now.
I like it.
Looks super Sonic. It's like Venom, that ain't... don't pick FD, guy. Don't be a
Venom's sad. Actually a sick stage, isn't it?
It is, but like...
when you fly through the cave...
yeah, and you bounce off the... you kill someone at 200, they bounce off the walls, you just come on.
Cave's awesome. Alright, we got Dream Lane. That's what I thought he would counterpick first,
Well, I think he got bodied... not bodied, but... kind of one of those games happened last time they played on Dreamland, so...
Kai did a laser from the top platform, that's so good, it just like beats that.
Yeah, it beats so many things. And he doesn't do it a whole lot, like he could do it a lot more than he does. A lot of the time he comes down with an aerial, hoping to like start a combo or whatever.
Nice combo. I mean, Kai's moving pretty well, like this move is sick.
Good to see that we actually look like we're improving at the moment. Like, movement's gotten a lot better.
Yeah, movement's...
in general.
I say movement's sick.
Except mine's shit.
Yeah. I mean, It has its days.
Yeah.
Luigi movements.
Alright. Classic ace strats. Back for a full smash.
Did you see Ace run for the train?
I heard behind me, I was playing Kai.
He got the time off someone, and then he just, like, screamed and ran out the door.
I heard the scream, funny. I was wondering what the hell that was, I'm gonna have to watch the VODs.
It's pretty funny.
Sounds like something Ace would do.
Yeah, we might have been able to see it on, like, the, player
cam.
Definitely
get the running player cam.
Dude, what's the chances of him coming back because he missed it? Like last time. Oh, classic bowling. Exactly.
Classic bowling.
Exactly, Euro.
Surprise Kai doesn't just angle shield straight down when he's on flat. I guess it's the shield drops, but the amount of times he's been shield poked this game. I think he could do put it down so you can go back to the shield drop later.
He's doing really well though.
Yeah, like other than the shield pose. Like he's pretty much been in control this whole game.
Oh, I'm...
PC Chris fell for that. I did not.
Oh, what an
air
dodge.
Such a good air dodge.
Kai's
too ready for it.
Kai is moving. Kai is on the top platform. Nick, not a fan.
Yep.
One of the reasons that the stage is so bad for Marth is just so hard to get up and cover those platforms.
That's gonna be it.
Alright, let's come down to the wire.
Kai knows, that's just how it works.
Dude, last stock kick in effect.
Yeah.
I wonder why he went to that platform back there. Nick, dude.
You force Falco to kind of come up.
Yeah. Ooh, that's it. Gone to game five.
Right.
I'm actually really surprised. Yeah, well done to Kai.
Definitely lost the power of the Chaos Emeralds in that one. Back to regular.
Are we
going to
see FD?
I assume so, but he might. Yeah.
Kai practices on the stage.
But it's still Space Animal Marth on FD.
Oh, his shield pressure is looking crisp.
I think this is why he picked up Yoshi's, was he assumed he could get a whole lot of shield pressure, but he's starting it all from the lasers, which is...
Yeah. Ooh. Oh yeah, Nick. No slouch when it comes to power shield.
Yeah, sure. I wonder if he's taken the spring out on his controller. I know he used to do that back in the day, but I'm not sure if he still does it.
Nick or Kai?
Nick. Kai doesn't do that.
Dude, Kai...
Kai doesn't need to power shield lasers, he just shoots them.
Kai going absolutely ham on his controller if you look at the player cam. Alright.
Kai loves pressing it.
Ooh, ends it with the tipper. Yeah, that's good choice.
I wish the SFGC guys were selling coke again, just so I could get the rank.
Oh yeah, no, that'd be handy.
He's going in. Power saving, Nick.
Yeah.
Oh, that sucks.
Oh, that's really unlucky. Oh, these power shields. Power shielding with the back of the shield.
Phantom jab. I don't know what Nick's been doing.
Oh no.
Kai's
still in it though. He just can't get grabbed. And like,
if he gets grabbed, he's in trouble.
Because that's a lot of extra credit.
Gotta stop shooting these high lasers though. Nick's not looking to go get in the air, he's looking for a grab.
Yeah. Nice. Gonna Moth killer him?
Ooh,
oh, he expected him to go on stage. Yeah, Kai can't get greedy for this.
Now he's in trouble. A really good DI though. Saves him from that. Thankfully, Kai, it's not Ace chain grabbing him, so he lived.
Yeah. Ace
will hit you at 90 every single time.
Oh, what DI though. That was great DI.
Didn't matter in the slightest, but sometimes that's all you need to get back into the game.
Yeah. I mean, like, if Nick some reason didn't grab ledge.
Yeah.
Waits out the spot ledge. That would have been a good time for high laser.
Yeah.
Ooh. Oh.
Yep.
Reverse. Oh! He wanted that. Reverse,
he wanted
but,
the
yeah.
Down air. Oh. Gorilla Boy, Grand Champion. Once again, of SFGC round 3 are we up to? That sounds right.
Yeah.
I assume you're routing one and
so
two.
So I assume we're going to be packing up the stream pretty quickly.
Yeah, I feel like Kai's going to press a lot of buttons on you.
Alright.
Yeah. Okay.
Alright. Yep. Alright.
Do you want to interview Gorilla Boy?
Oh, do you want to do it?
Not really. My throat's getting real sore.
Alright. I'll get him on.
Yo, Nick.
Jungle secures another tournament. How do you feel about the game five grand finals?
Yeah, I mean, Kai played very well. He didn't know he's played against me in a long time. Yeah, not
too happy.
I don't know what's happening to me, Ruben. I used to be a clutch lord, and I'm not anymore.
I reckon last stock Nick still with me. I mean,
I used to steal it out. I used to get the last stock and be like, "All right."
Yeah,
fine,
I thought you had that.
And I just made like, sorry, crucial errors in the last stock,
like that up B, man.
Yeah, I meant to side B. I'm not clutch anymore. I have to get that sorted for DI another day.
Yeah. So, what are your plans for that?
I don't know. Get two stocked.
Alright.
Shoutouts to the jungle.
Oh, yeah.
Shoutouts to everyone in chat. Yeah, it was a good set.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
See Ace running for the train.
Yeah,
Classic.
He was legging it.
I wish I could say that again.
Well, I barely made a profit. I love SAFGC.
Oh, yeah. How much did you spend? $15?
Yep.
Yeah, damn.
I think I made $12 today. Not bad, you know?
Not bad. Yeah, no, this was a pretty disappointing turnout. We got like 9. I mean, that American guy didn't have a controller, so couldn't enter.
Yeah. It's just the core group that we're getting these days.
Yeah, we actually need
Ruben?
Yep.
Puff guy. Musket?
Musket.
Flow Rats.
Mm-hmm.
Kaiser. I'm just saying words.
Euro wasn't here.
He certainly wasn't. No. And Donut wasn't here. Donut I haven't seen in a little bit.
Donut? I don't think Donut's going to come to anything unless you're going to say team with me in doubles.
I would have teamed with him in doubles.
Do we even have a doubles?
Donut was in the chat today, right?
He was.
What are you doing, Donut?
No, he's not in chat, is he?
But he was, and I'm sure he's got ears everywhere, you know. He's probably going to watch the VODs of this. He's probably going to watch the VODs of me talking to you. Like, oh, I hear Nick was talking on stream. I can, you know. He's got a little soundboard at home that he, like, clips out little voice snippets of me. And he makes it say things like, Donut, you are my friend.
Well, you just said it for
it's
him.
It's like a little shrine that he's got with, like... Like 100 most common English words as spoken by SA Nick. Picture of me. Maybe a bunch of bananas.
He's making a clone. Making a robot of you.
Yeah. Yeah. It's alright. I mean, unfortunately, technology hasn't advanced that far. I didn't think.
Yeah.
But if anyone could make it happen, and if anyone has the willpower to do it, it's probably Donut.
He is studying IT.
Yeah.
I mean, who knows? He's probably programming some sort of SANIC program right now.
Yeah. He's just like a little straw, like scarecrow man with like a photo of me and a little tape recorder on the inside. Just in his room.
Oh, yeah.
Shout out to Donut, I miss that guy. No one makes me feel as welcome and comfortable as Donut, and also as occasionally uncomfortable.
I love Donut.
How was your tournament?
Good. Played Florets. I lost. If you didn't see it. Then I played Musket. Kinda got...
I did see you play Florets. I think you were on stream?
Yeah, I was.
Yeah, I was
commentating. Yeah, you probably commentated it, yeah. And then I played Musket off stream, because no one wants
to see Musket on stream?
Well, no one wants Samus Son Peach on stream. No, actually, we're just running out of time, I reckon. But...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, that was after Musket was on stream for the hype winners, whatever it was.
Yeah. And then...
And Kai was moving really fast in that set. What the hell?
Yeah, no joke.
I don't see that very often. Kai's been practicing.
He was going crazy. And then, yeah, Musket shows he is the stitch face god, pulls two stitch faces on me and a bum on. So yeah.
Yeah, like he is the stitch face god. It's because he's the lamest player. He just camps. He's a camper. I said you're a camper. You're a stitch face puller.
He wasn't getting a lot of stitches in Peach.
Just approach Musket. Just go in.
Yeah. Cut. Yeah, Musket getting defensive.
Pulling turnips like a big baby.
Whoa! Oh,
whoa.
Shit.
Okay, one of you guys, unlock this.
Yeah, I got you. Put it down. Yep, we good.
You good?
Alright,
cool.
Alright. Alright, so...
I was...
Will Monkey Man be at DI another day?
I don't think so.
Damn. You're gonna only have half the jungle.
Well, you know, the best half of the jungle. At least in terms of melee skill.
Yep.
Monkey Man definitely good at cultivating a brand, I will say that.
It's not bad.
I keep trying to not cough because I know I'm wearing headphones. And then eventually the cough just gets too strong within me.
Oh, dude, I hate
you
holding...
You breathe out the cough?
I hate holding in a cough. It's the worst feeling.
Yeah. Alright, so we're probably going to wrap this up soonish.
Oh, yeah.
Shoutouts to Chromeboy, Zanbot, Kaizmo, Aussie Smurf, Dr. Skeleton, Eurotripping, Euoikadifs, Cable2142, Lil Viz, Mikuia, Quetzalcoatl87, Saucy Oz, and Sydney Smash 2. Do you think 87 is his birth date?
Probably.
Because I think it might be. He's an old man.
That makes sense.
He's nearly 30.
How do you say his full name?
Quetzalcoatl.
Quetzalcoatl.
It's an Aztec god of the something.
Right.
I used to be all up in the Aztec knowledge because Age of Empires 2, the Conqueror's expansion.
I love Age of Empires 2.
Yeah.
As many people do.
Yeah, I did my primary school project in year 7 on the Aztecs.
I used to play Age of Empires 1 and 2. At my grandparents' house when they were babysitting me, so yeah.
Nice, me too.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah.
Dope.
Yeah, shout outs to my grandparents.
Shout outs to dads. It's Father's Day today.
Oh, no shit. I sent my dad a text saying, "Happy Father's Day!" exclamation mark. Keep on rocking in the free world, etc., etc.
Yeah.
And he sent me a really long text.
Oh, yeah, well.
I was trying to win, but I wasn't trying to win. I was kind of making a joke about how we always half-ass it on, like, birthdays and Father's Days. And dude, he was like, "Hey, it means a lot that you contacted me today, Nick."
Dude, I owned you on Father's Day. I bought my dad a six-pack of beer.
What beer?
Vale Pale Ale.
Yeah.
Straight up. And I made him pancakes, so yeah.
Well, do you live with him?
Yes. Yeah, that makes sense, so... I mean, yeah. I'm fresh out of high school, so...
I never see my dad. I saw him, actually, like, 3 weeks ago. We got beer, and I told him I had a big tournament coming up. It was OHN. And he sent me a text after losing to Wibbles saying, preparation is key. And I said, didn't respond to that one, actually. He's right.
Yeah.
But wasn't having it.
Alright. So, what are we doing now?
I guess we wait for Kaizmo.
Kaizmo.
And then I catch the bus home. To my house, where I live. And I see my housemates. Liam's moving out, dude. It's actually
is
the
Liam
end of an
Lem?
Era. Liam is Lem.
Dude, I played him at my first tournament.
Dude, Lem is the sickest dude, but he's moving out because he's... He was like, you know, Nick, I'm 34. I've lived at your house for like 2.5 years. And I was like, our house, Liam.
He's
whatever.
34.
He's old man. He's an old man. I'm like 23.
Damn.
Yeah. He's a big old baby.
I played him at my first tournament, and I lost to him. I didn't even know how I did it. I took a game. It's hell funny, though, because, like...
He's the best, dude. You lost to Lem. That's so funny. Lem is actually the truth.
it was so, like, low quality of gameplay that we'd got a huge crowd. Like, you know, Jasper and, like, Jeremy and all their mates were watching it.
Was I yelling? I was probably yelling for
Lem.
No, you were
playing your dumb game against Scraddles with Pichu. You can just see me and Lem's game in the background. And there's, like, a bunch of, like, school kids crowding around our setup.
That was a good tournament.
Yeah.
And that's because I've been practicing with Lem. I was practicing the Pichu Ice Climbers matchup.
That was my first tournament where you beat Scraddles with Pichu.
He deserved it. I don't know why, but for some reason he deserved it. I will always look fondly on that memory of beating Scraddles with Pichu.
No. I won't.
It was... Come on.
Dude, I don't understand why you had to do it.
Because it was funny.
Not to me.
Well, it was funny to me, and at the end of the day...
Pretty sure everyone was...
Isn't yourself the only person that matters when you tell a joke? It's like, whether anyone else laughs at your joke, doesn't matter.
I'm pretty sure after...
Laughing at your own jokes is the most important thing.
I'm pretty sure everyone just, like, after they heard that you beat him, they just, like, put their head down and just, like, God damn it.
Yeah, this was a different Nick, I would say. This was a Nick that had a lot of fire in his belly. More so, I still have a bit of fire in the belly, but it's like residual fire. It only comes out when I lose now. But back then, the fire was like, I had something to prove every minute of every day. And that minute of that day, I had to prove that I could beat Scraddles with Pichu.
Right.
Right now, the fire, it lays dormant within me. It says...
I thought it was coming back for DI another day.
Oh yeah, I've been practicing. But that's like, it's still motivated by salt. The salt, the fire only comes out when I'm salty. It's like a, I don't actually know what kind of fire. Like a, I'm gonna make a fool of myself because I don't know anything about chemistry.
Yeah, we just.
What happens if you burn salt? Does it like glow a funny color? Who knows?
I don't know.
It's like the pinky green. Blue flame of
there's so
burning
many different
salty
flames.
Copper.
So many different flames. Learn that in year 10 chemistry or something.
What do you mean different types of flames? You mean like
colors? Yeah, that's what I meant. I guess they're different types, though.
I mean, yeah. Still flames.
Yeah. That's right.
Anyway, one of those flames is the flame that I have. For
which
melee.
Color is it?
It's like
if you had to guess.
It's like a bluey, pinky, green.
That's cool.
And it comes out when I'm salty, which is why I'm very excited about DI another day, because I don't really... I don't know. I feel like people are sleeping on the gorilla.
Yeah, you got seated second this time. Rifle.
No, but
cider.
I just mean like the community is sleeping on gorilla. Boy.
I heard Gareth at next major tournament is going to bring printout sheets of the...
Yeah, like...
Of the song.
Like hymns. I'm keen.
That's out. Is he coming to SXE?
No. I'm not even sure if he'll be at EB Expo, because the Queenslanders and myself and a couple other people have something
please
very special planned.
Me, like...
Oh, is that what
about EB Expo? Like
EB Expo, EB Expo is where you can burn 150 of your sweet dollar EDs for the privilege of playing in an esports arena with some of Australia's finest Melee players. It's a expo for all manner of things, I assume. Yeah. I haven't looked into it. All I know is it's very expensive. And I probably have to go.
Who's going? Do you know? Is it in Victoria?
Probably Wibbles.
Is it in Victoria?
It's in Sydney.
Oh, Sydney.
Probably SD. Probably Miles, since he tends to make it out to everything.
Does Legacy help him out with that shit?
You what? Legacy?
Yeah.
Legacy are apparently pretty legit.
Yeah. I remember them having a pretty legit LoL team. So well,
yeah. Dude, did I tell you Gareth made me a contract? He went through some contract generating site, which generates this really long-winded contract that's like standard form.
Did he read it all?
No. Basically, the contract was like, the names were Monkey Man and Gorilla Boy, and the contract was literally just, I will pay you $1,000. And I was like, Gareth, I don't, like, if by some chance I am able to prosecute this contract, I still probably won't, but like, this is foolish.
Probably won't.
If things go south, you know, me and Gareth have a big falling out. I'm gonna be right there with that contract.
Damn.
I'll appear in court, you know. Gorilla Boy, can you please stand? Yep, it's me.
Alright, I kind of want to go now.
Do it.
See you, dude.
Laters. Goodbye, stream. It's been real.
Yep.
This has been
Naruvia, or Ruben, signing off.
And this has been Gorilla Boy from the jungle.
See you guys.
Laterinos. Actually, you know what? Is there anyone else here that... Okay, Kai's back.
Dude, Kai's packing up. You can have a few words with Kai, Mel.
No, get Kai to turn this off. I don't want to leave it. Say, Kai, turn the stream off.
Why can't you do it?
Because he's all the way... You're closer.
Fucking hate you.
You are. Yeah, I want to be able to leave. Huh? I want to leave.
Hey, dude, quickly, how'd you feel about that?
I felt like I played okay. I felt like you played faster than usual. I felt like a couple of little clutch situations where I'm usually very good, I just, like, jitted and missed my controller, which is very worrying to me because I'm usually very clutch.
I felt like that last bit as well. Like, you just didn't get the usual Nick stuff, I guess.
But, you know, I think and you played actually quite well.
I did try to move faster. I don't know. I'm always, like, so fucking retarded. Like, when it comes to, like, melee, and I'm just, like, I'll do something, I'm like, that was a mix-up. How did he see that? And I just realized, I haven't been moving. I'm an idiot.
Yeah, you gotta
move. And I'm just, like, I'm just so lazy. I'm actually, lazy as fuck when it comes to movement in
this
game. When
you move, good things happen. I always hit you with down tilt, though, and I always get a dash attack, because you always dash backwards. Don't do that. Like, 4 times, that's it.
Yeah, you did. I have to take ground with dash dance more.
Well, when I hit you with the down tilt, your gut reaction is just to run away, and I always get that. Because, like, yeah.
Mm.
You gotta not do the same thing every time in those little itty-bitty situations. Because, like, dash attack, if I land it, it's so huge.
It was funny because when you dash attack this time, I detect away every time instead of...
You take, like... in sometimes as well, but like you always roll tech, and so I could always cover it on reaction.
Yeah, I know, that's what I mean. I was always like, I always tech in place, so I'll just do everything except tech in place, and then I realize I'm like, you're an idiot again. You're just double the idiot now. Anyway, thanks for watching, everyone. We gotta pack up. Bye. Follow the stream, please, everyone. The details are up above me. Kaizmer_ on Twitter. I think I might change that soon, though, to KP_Kaizer. Anywho, yeah. Please follow if you haven't already. I'm actually really excited for DI another day too. I'm gonna watch. I'm actually. Can we just play Falco Dodos all the time?
I'm trying to practice, dude.
Me too.
You also would have to practice against Spud. I will play some Falco.
Good.
But like,
I need to do that because I wanna at least get a game of Seed. That'd be really good. If I got a game of Seed, that'd be really good.
It's good to have lofty goals.
Hey, I mean, he's just a spacey, easy. I can.
As
just,
I said, it's good.
Once you hit him, there's just every other space. Anyway, alright.
It's just playing the same game as you. It's the same height, more or less, same amount of hands and feet.
Same clothes.
Same physical capabilities, more or less, although he can do that dash dance thing. That's really hard.
You caught my turnaround laser heaps as well. Anyway.
Yeah.
With the dash attack. Okay. We'll talk about it more later. I have to pack up. All right. Thanks for watching, everyone, and bye-bye. Cool. GG.